WRKO Boston, the album station. It's 8 o'clock with Charlie and Harrigan. WRKO, Charlie and Harrigan going our own way this morning, and hopefully going your way. It's 5 minutes after 8 o'clock, 8:05 at WRKO.
Very shortly now, the Charlie and Harrigan Staff Orchestra, ladies and gentlemen, under the baton of Skitch Ferguson.
Very shortly.
We'll
tell you when, Skitch.
We'd like to explain a little bit about our orchestra. We're the only radio show that I know of that has its own orchestra standing by the Skitch Ferguson Stereophonic, or is
Come
it?
On,
No, not yet. We'll tell you when. But anyway, Skitch, I know we want to go delve into your musical background a little bit. I know that your main claim to musical fame is that you once soloed briefly on Wee Bonnie Baker's version of Oh Johnny.
That's right. And my soprano saxophone in the Earl Tucker Band a few years ago. We have a follow-up record, by the way, that will be coming out very soon. I think you'll be hearing it right here on WRKU very, very shortly. We'll be following up that big hit, Johnny, and I think a lot of folks, a lot of our fans have been waiting for this one. We are forcing a single out of our next album, and it will be a follow-up to that hit.
Okay, now also in the orchestra...
As heard first, exclusively on WRKU. Yeah,
thank you very much, Kitch. As you well know, we have, of course, a couple of the members of the band, Bix and Muzzy, who work exclusively in the trumpet and in the drum section.
That is correct. Yes, indeed.
Thank you very much. We're very glad to be here.
We also have Easy Elliott Kilgore, ladies and gentlemen, the world's only three-finger guitarist.
Now, we might mention this is very tricky for Easy Elliott Kilgore. Again, he only has three fingers, and those are on his fritting hand.
That is correct.
Very, very difficult for him, and of course...
But he strums well.
Yeah, needless to say, we do have the mad organist, Matt. How's that again, Matt? Okay, we'll get to the wine very shortly. So there you have the entire orchestra, ladies and gentlemen.
We'll be presenting a musical selection for you a little later on this morning, ladies and gentlemen.
Okay,
five, 10 minutes. As soon as we can get some black coffee down the...
Mad organist, he needs it badly.
There are a lot of ways to be a part of what's going on in and around Boston.
Metro Guide.
Hey, every Thursday, Metro Guide is front of the Daily Transcript, the South Middlesex News, the Winchester Star, and many other high-quality suburban newspapers. If you don't already read your local newspaper, try it. And then on Thursday, read Metro Guide. We're going to check in with a traffic report now. Park AO Commuter Control and Carolyn Murdoch. Carolyn?
Okay, coming in from Route 2 now, you've got congestion at Rings Avenue as you head towards Memorial Drive. 128 northbound is heavy and slow from Route 24 in Randolph to Great Plain Avenue in Needham. And main trains are on time. South Acton, though, you will have slight delays all day today. Logan Airport flight operations are running smoothly. From WRKO Commuter Control, this is Carolyn Murdoch.
It's 8 minutes now after 8 o'clock. Oh, we want to play this for Francis, our favorite waiter over at the Holiday Inn. Waitress, I'm sorry. Francis, this is for you. Charlie and Harrigan on WRKO.
It's mine, it's not the first.
WRKO, it's 11 minutes after 8 o'clock. 8:11 in the morning. Charlie and Harrigan, just a minute before you do anything else. I take exception to what you just said to me while that record was
I didn't fun. Say anything to you. I merely passed along a message that was said to me by Mr. Hobbs, our radio station general manager, vice president of broadcasting RKO General.
Yes, I know. Admiral Hobbs said something about me and the waitress.
All he said was you dedicated that song, Hopelessly Devoted to
well,
you.
You dedicated it to
Francis the Waiter.
No, waitress.
And you changed that to Francis the Waitress at the Holiday Inn.
Well, I just want, she's just a very nice lady, and she,
Hobbs said that. He said it didn't take Harrigan long to start hitting on the waitress.
I am not in any way or shape or form. No, we're just Francis and I are just good friends. She brings me my Bloody Mary. So
to your room or...
no!
Win up to $7,777.77 at Finest Supermarket Super 7 Sweepstakes. It's easy to play. Get your free game ticket with each store visit. No purchase is necessary. Simply insert your ticket into the computer. You get two exciting chances to win. Be an instant cash winner with the right combination or win $7,777.77 at their special drawing. So go on in and win your chance at the Super 7 Party Sweepstakes at your finest supermarket. Super 7 participating finest stores are in Massachusetts, Rhode Island, Connecticut, and New Hampshire. And the overall game odds are 1-79. We are going to give you a little weather report here. Actually, it's a pretty big weather report with Jordan Rich standing by the National Weather Service at Logan. Jordan?
Good morning. How are you?
Just fine, Jordan. And I would assume that you are standing by out there with the radio on, waiting to hear our studio orchestra play for the first time.
I am just sitting here on the edge of my chair.
Many people.
I'm also very excited because we just got a report in on the rain that is falling now just northwest of Worcester. And you can draw the shower line from Manchester, New Hampshire to Pittsfield. And chances are we're going to pick up some of that scattered shower activity and thunderstorms this afternoon. probably afternoon time, maybe 1 or 2 o'clock. Right now it's hazy, cloudy, and warm with a high in the 70s and a lot of humidity around. Now this afternoon, showers, as I said, then cooler air. Quite a difference later on. That cold front will usher in Canadian high pressure as well, which means things will start to clear up by tonight. Only partly cloudy tonight and cool, the low in the 50s. Tomorrow, mostly sunny and very cool, the low in the low 60s. And we can look forward to another good day on Thursday with increasing clouds, but a very high temperature only. And this is Jordan Rich for WRKO.
13 minutes after 8 o'clock. Good morning to you. Charlie and Harrigan on WRKO.
Keep your heart open, cause the love is fire.
WRKO, Charlie and Harrigan is going to be all right. I guess it's 17 minutes after 8 o'clock in the morning. It's 8:17, wow. And we are so very, very happy. Our band is already in set and going to play a number for you.
This is the moment I think you've waited for.
I think this is the moment I've waited for, a chance to solo before some of the music appreciators of lovers of Bart.
Yes, Big. I think that you're going to be playing the trumpet solo on this. Is that correct?
Anyway, yes, I'm going to be later, playing the drums with this.
Without further ado, let's get right into this because okay. You know, a lot of people are probably parking their cars and not getting out to go to work. And
because
like
they want
that.
To hear the orchestra play.
Well, let's go ahead and give them a little brief sampling of the Charlie Harrigan Stereophonic Recording Orchestra and Quadrophonic Choir. And the artistry of our very own Vic Spiderback on the flugelhorn. Come on, that's you. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7.
First time people ever call in requesting commercials.
Last night, Mary Keating celebrated her birthday.
Joseph Aspirin for Children, the one children's doctors recommend most. Use only as directed.
Thank goodness for St. Joseph.
Who knows more about children's medicine?
Ed Walsh knows more about everything. Watch this.
Thank you very much, Charlie, and good morning, everyone.
I have faith in you, Ed. You see there, I have faith in you.
Yeah, okay, well, let me see if I can do my best now. Whitman Hanson Regional High School. This is Ed Walsh, 68 News and Information. Now from WRKO, Charlie and Harrigan.
The CNH Show presents tips for insomniacs. If you have trouble waking up in the morning, try sleeping with your mouth over a rooster.
When you were young.
In the morning, Charlie and Harrigan on WRKO. Whoops. 25 minutes now before 9 o'clock in the morning.
Doggone it, we made it all the way to here. I don't believe that.
Well, that was pretty good. I mean, for us, you know.
Better than yesterday, I guess. I don't know. It's 8:35 right now.
I was just looking at the reason I didn't come in immediately. I was reading something in the sports section that I don't agree with at all. Cincinnati Reds manager Sparky Anderson accused the Atlanta Braves owner Ted Turner of trying to hype the gate Sunday at the expense of the pennant race by letting 39-year-old Jim Boughton pitch against the Los Angeles Dodgers. I don't think that was it at all. Boughton was doing all right. As a matter of fact, I think the first three innings he had a no-hitter. And then, of course, they started tagging him a little bit. But I don't think that was bad at all. Now, I think maybe Boughton may be used in the future as probably a relief pitcher. But I really disagree with what Sparky said. He said that Commissioner Bowie Kuhn should take some action against the Braves for toying with the integrity of baseball. And I don't see Boughton's debut as that much slap in the face of...
Yeah, I just think Sparky, you know, would rather have had Boughton debut against Cincinnati. I think that...
Yeah.
Bucko proved it to me.
Traffic check-in time now. Let's check in with the WRKO Commuter Control and Carolyn Murdoch. Carolyn?
Okay, traffic inbound on the expressway. On public transportation, MBTA lines are all on a normal schedule this morning. Boston Main trains, with the exception of the South Acton line, all on or within a few minutes of schedule. No problems with flight operations out at Logan Airport. From WRKO Commuter Control, this is Carolyn Murdoch.
22 minutes before 9 o'clock. Good morning, Charlie and Harrigan from WRKO.
WRKO, Charlie and Harrigan, money can't buy me love, and love is all I need. It's 19 minutes now before the hour 9 o'clock with Charlie and Harrigan at WRKO, and good morning, everybody. It's a weird day. Weather-wise, we're going to be checking in just a few seconds here and finding out exactly how weird it's going to be. In the meantime, if you missed our musical salute this morning to you, Boston, then you know not how weird we can be. Sometimes our musicians get a little carried away, as they did this morning.
They've been carried away many
times.
Three
of them were carried away a little later.
Kicking and screaming, right?
Just your afternoon, y'all.
This year, the word is Greece. Greece, the original movie soundtrack album, starring John Travolta and Olivia Newton-John. The 50s were never slicker. The 70s were never hotter. This year, the word is Grease, the original movie soundtrack, a double album of musical dynamite on records and tapes from RSO, the record-breaking record company. Put a little Grease in your life.
Available at all Strawberries, Musicland, Discount Record Stores, and Good Vibrations in Walpole and Canton. We're going to put a little Grease into your life and a little weather into your ear, ladies and gentlemen, with Jordan Rich.
Good morning, and Grease is the word as far as the humidity is concerned. This is Jordan Rich for WRKO.
Come on over to my house, and we'll make some fun.
Don't be a smart mouth with the weatherman.
17 minutes before 9 o'clock, CNH on WRKO.
KO Charlie and Harrigan. It's about 13 minutes here before 9 o'clock in the morning with CNH. And there's Herman Willis in the newsroom with all the news we need to know. Herman Willis, sir, come in, please.
Herman Willis, sir, award-winning Bubble News Chief. Minutes ahead, 1 second count, WRKO 2020 News. From Action Central, this dateline, Ringling Brothers Barnum and Bailey, well-known contortionist Sidney Nussbaum died yesterday when he fell asleep and choked on his big toe. We'll have film at 11.
WRKO Charlie and Harrigan. Got about 10 minutes before 9 o'clock now.
Extra bites. Extra bites. Butterfinger gives you extra bites.
Butterfinger gives you more of what you buy a candy bar for.
Yeah, a commercial by Dennis John Bailey's vocal coach. That's something. Are we ready in there, Ed? I guess you must be.
I think we are, yes.
All right.
Standing by, as it were.
All right, thank you, as it were. Thank you very much, Charlie. Good morning, everyone. When lightning struck the football field at Whitman Hanson Regional High School yesterday afternoon, tragedy did as well. Government Center. This is Ed Walsh, 68 News and Information. Now from WRKO, Charlie and Harrigan.
Okay, you paid the money. You're expecting to see a professional show, so let's not waste any more time. Let's go with professional show business. Hey!
WRKO Boston, the album station. It's 9:02. You're with Charlie and Harrigan and Foreigner, and I am freezing.
Boston, the album station. Good morning. It's a minute before 7. You're with Charlie and Harrigan. We've got some Monday night football tickets to give away in just minutes.
I would never get
WRKO. Good morning, everybody. It's 2 minutes after 7 o'clock, and it's Charlie and Harrigan. 7 o'clock. We really do have some tickets to give away this hour. We're going to be giving away in just a couple of minutes, as a matter of fact, and we've decided that we're going to give them away to people who have to go to that Monday night football game because they are football crazy.
That's right. We want some, people that win this that would really appreciate a football game. So, why don't we take the fifth caller right now?
Right now, okay.
That's about right. And we're going to talk to him a little bit, and then we'll be talking to him on the air about this, because we just can't give these tickets away.
And for good reason, Mr. Travis, you should make the people compete for it.
That's right, absolutely. You know, I believe that's true.
If they just get the tickets just by calling in, what have they done to deserve it?
That's true.
Well, I'd just give them to somebody, because that's how you guys got them. Somebody just gave them to you, and you're giving them away.
I think we should make them work.
Okay, caller number five.
Well, there are millions of starving children right now in India.
You tell those starving children to go have a bowl of oatmeal, will you?
When your heart to fear, the danger I hear is ringing.
Wait a minute, I just hit the wrong one. I can't do that. It's traffic time, for heaven's sake. And we've got to check into WRKO Commuter Control with Carolyn Murdoch. Carolyn, if you're there, come in, please.
I'm right here.
Oh, thank you.
Okay, and this is the way it looks right now. Inbound from WRKO Commuter Control, this is Carolyn Murdoch.
5 minutes now after 7 o'clock. Good morning to you, Charlie and Harrigan on WRKO.
WRKO and Charlie and Harrigan, and good morning, because, ladies and gentlemen, because at 9 minutes after 7 o'clock, we are already out lighting our smudge pots. Being from California, we assume you light a smudge pot whenever it's going to be frosty. We thought we might go ahead and bring Jordan in here a little early and let Jordan tell us exactly what the problem is with the weather. What's going on, anyhow?
Well, I don't know if you could call it a problem. Direct from the National Weather Service, this is Jordan Rich for WRKO.
Well, why did I call that a problem, for heaven? Of course it's not a problem, but, you know, frost is something we're not used to. Let me talk to you for just a minute now about the $7,777.77 that you might win at Finest Supermarket Super 7 Sweepstakes. It's easy to play. You get your free game ticket with each store visit. No purchase is necessary. You simply insert your ticket into the computer. You get two exciting chances to win. Be an instant cash winner with the right combination or win $7,777.77 at this special drawing. So go on in and win your chance at the Super 7 Party Sweepstakes at your Finest Supermarket Super 7 participating Finest stores are in Massachusetts, Rhode Island, Connecticut, and New Hampshire. Overall game odds are 1-79. And now I think we have a contestant standing by.
Yes, we do. Good morning, David. This is David McKinney on the phone with us. How are you doing this morning?
Oh, not too bad.
All right, Dave, I'm really excited about this because this is going to be our first contest, and you're up now for the, you know, to try to get a couple of tickets to go see the Pats this Monday, right?
Right.
Okay, have you ever played football before?
Yep. High school.
Yeah. Oh, really? What high school?
Well,
it's up in the Berkshires. Okay, well, and what position did you play?
Defensive tackle.
Defensive tackle, great big dude. All
absolutely
right.
Perfect.
This is great because, well, I'll tell you what we're going to do. We're going to make you a halfback on this play, okay? All right, now, the way we're going to do this, Charlie, you're small and quick. Why don't you play the quarterback position?
Okay,
and I'll play the center, okay?
Okay.
So I'll center, here's what we're going to do, Dave.
I don't like this.
Hey, Dave?
Yeah?
I'm not real happy about it myself. I'm bending over for it. All right, Dave, I'm going to hike the ball back to Charlie, okay, on the count of three. And then he's going to hand it off to you, and I want you to run around your own end, okay? Think you can do it? I'm sure you can, all right?
All right, let's give it a try.
Get in the back.
All right, red pad.
All right.
Brown 54, okay, blue 32, blue 32. Wing what? Right, wing right. What's ready,
he,
set.
What's he talking
about? Hut.
All right, there's the ball. Quick, David,
here.
Take it. There he goes.
David, take it.
That's it, Dave. Keep it up, son. You got to get around your own end. That's tough.
Attaboy, you can do it.
Hey. Fantastic. Oh, fantastic. The kid threw himself right into the ground. Look at that.
I'm Marty from Snyder Leather Factory Outlet. Come see us at Snyder Leather, 342 Western Avenue, Brighton. Open Monday through Friday till 9, Saturday till 5. In Haverhill, we're at Railroad Square, and in Providence on Elmwood Avenue.
It's 13 minutes now after 7 o'clock. We've got more tickets to give away a little bit later on this morning, so stay tuned to Charlie and Harrigan. And congratulations, Dave McKinney ran.
How do you do that?
I know that.
WRKO, Charlie and Harrigan, good morning. It's 16 minutes after 7 o'clock with CNH. You heard Jordan say a little earlier, it looks like frost tonight, but it'll be a beautiful day today. And as a matter of fact, he said, and I don't understand this, but he said you'd be able to see the lights of Montreal.
Oh.
Today. Didn't he say that?
Yeah, he did. Yeah.
He said you'd be able to see that he went up on some kind of a mountain. What's he talking about?
I don't know how to tell you this, but I think the man's on drugs.
I want that sinus medicine.
Headache sinus medicine in the bright red box. Take when needed, only as directed.
S-I-N-E-O-F-F. Sinon.
7 o'clock in the morning. Good morning to you. Charlie and Harrigan on WRKO. WRKO, Charlie and Harrigan, good morning. It's 20 minutes after 7 o'clock, and Charlie and Harrigan have the question of the morning for you now. What can you get when you buy new denim jeans?
You can get stiff and you can get scratchy. That's what you can get. And you get a shade of blue the jeans maker put into those jeans. So you spend weeks wearing and washing to get the jeans soft and the blue to fade down. And by the time your jeans are broken in, they start to wear out. But now there's a better way for getting new jeans really soft and faded, and it's called Soft and Fade. They were going to call it Peaches and Cream, but it didn't sound as good as Soft and Fade. You wash new jeans with Soft and Fade in a washing machine once. Before you wear them, your new jeans come out as soft as if they've been washed 20 times. And you get just the shade of blue you want, too. There's a color guide on the back of the Soft and Fade box that tells you how long to wash your jeans to get any shade from very blue to barely blue or any blue in between. And when you use Soft and Fade, your jeans are still new. Still strong, except now they look and feel like comfortable old friends. Soft and Fade, it beats stiff and scratchy every time. You can buy Soft and Fade right now at Shaw's and other fine stores. And we're going to check in with Ed Walsh. Ed?
Thank you very much, Charlie. Good morning, everyone. The vote, WRKO News Time, 727. Up to 51 degrees at Logan Airport, still 51 downtown at the Government Center. This is Ed Walsh, 68 News and Information. Now from WRKO, Charlie and Harrigan.
Well, Charlie was almost late again today. Someone spilled DentuGrip on his toilet seat. We're sorry about that.
Thank you very much. I'm rather fond of you. It's WRKO with Charlie and Harrigan. Good morning, folks. It is 27 minutes before 8 o'clock in the morning, and C&H have already given away a pair of tickets to a Patriots game that's coming up on Monday night, and we have another pair of tickets to give away a little later on this morning. So stand by. Don't touch that dial. That's Herman Willis in the newsroom with all the news we need to know. Herman Willis, sir, come in, please.
Good morning. This is Herman Willis, your award-winning mobile news chief. That's ahead 1 second count. And sad news this morning out of Hollywood, California. Jamie, the bionic woman, was discovered in a rundown clinic having an illegal radiator flush. We'll have Phil at 11.
Hello, it's Audrey. Seems we've got a problem. People are pretty dame and no good with Calico Cornet.
I'm totally confused. WRKO Commuter Control now, and Carolyn Murdoch with the traffic. I don't know.
With traffic from WRKO Commuter Control, this is Carolyn Murdoch.
All right, thank you. That was the traffic. Now here's the weather.
Oh, it's so beautiful. It's so beautiful. It just makes me want to go ride. Go and lie down in a bed of lilies.
A bed of lilies?
Of the valley.
Well, good. You want to get him some black coffee, and we'll see if we can... 25 minutes now before 8 o'clock. Sometimes I think we're overstaffed here, maybe. WRKO, Charlie and Harrigan. Good morning, everybody. It's about 21 minutes before 8 o'clock in the morning, and you heard our own, very own meteorologist a moment ago that it was a great day to lie on your back and in the lilies of the valley. I don't know what Jordan has to say about that. Perhaps we can bring him in now. What kind of a day is it going to be, Jordan?
Oh, second at motion. And tomorrow, maybe some showers by Friday. Direct from the National Weather Service, this is Jordan Rich for WRKO.
WRKO, Charlie and Harrigan. We love you like a couple of rocks, ladies and gentlemen. 17 minutes before 8 o'clock in the morning, and it is a beautiful day. It's going to be a nice but a cold night, and tomorrow will be a beautiful day, and the weather is just going to be...
Hi, guys.
Seymour Vermont, account executive at WRKO. We met you yesterday. You're back today to talk to us again.
Well, how are you guys doing here? How's it going? Now, what is this, about your third day?
Yeah, it's a little slow, but we're beginning to catch on. We're meeting some of the people. You were talking yesterday. You were trying to give us a lowdown on Boston.
I was telling you all about my boss, my immediate supervisor, of course, the lovely Austin What's-His-Name.
Right, Austin Walsh, you were talking about yesterday, and I thought perhaps you might continue that and explain some more of the people.
Well, what do you want to know? You want to know engineering? You want to know programming? You want to know management? I know everybody.
Let's go right to the top. Let's talk about management. We'll start at the top and work our way down.
You mean Marvelous Mark? Well,
no, I mean right to the top.
Oh, even higher than that?
I mean Mr. Hobbs.
Oh, is there somebody higher than Marvelous Mark?
Yes, indeed. Mr. Hobbs is our station manager, general manager, vice president, the whole thing.
Yes, he is.
Let's talk about him. You know him very well?
Yeah, I know him quite well. Of course, we don't get to see him. You know, it's not very often he'll allow us into his office or anything like that.
Yeah, he's in the ivory tower down at the end of the hall. I just wonder, what kind of a guy is he?
What kind of a guy is Mr. Hobbs, huh?
Yeah. Give us any background at all on him?
Well, let me think. Of course, I know, you know, he's a...
He's a pretty rugged individual. Yeah. I don't know if you've heard.
Seems like
that.
A tough, wiry type.
Well,
yeah.
I would have to be. You know, I mean, the man, grew up in Roxbury.
He did.
Yes, he did.
Irish Jack Hobbs.
Jack Hobbs grew up in
Oh, he doggone. That's
in Roxbury. And
surprising.
I've talked to him about that. I said, wasn't that a little tough? He said, no, not at all, man.
Being a minority, so to speak.
Well, first time he was a minority. He was the minority, and he said, no, it wasn't. We just got along just fine. He said, when they were kids, they used to play games, They had a favorite game they used to like to play with Mr. Hobbs.
What kind of a game? What was it?
It's called Pin the Tail on the Honky.
No soap gives you more deodorant protection than Dial.
Just like you should. With Dial, you'll always be made good.
You just can't buy a better deodorant soap.
Seems like a heck of a guy. You know, in shape, he looks like.
Yeah, he's in for a relatively good shape.
Physically,
yeah.
I mean, you know.
Yeah, I think so. I think, you know, he doesn't, he's not in.
Strides down the hall with a great deal of leadership. You know, he just exudes that. He's a confident man, you know.
He's not he's not a well man.
Obviously, he's a winner. Well to me.
He's
in great shape.
Well, he suffers from boom-boom phobia, but outside of that, there's
everybody's got a little problem here. He suffers from what?
Huh?
What does he suffer from?
Who's
it, Hobbs?
Oh, he suffers from boom-boom phobia. I don't know if you knew that.
Boom-boom, what is boom-boom phobia?
That is the fear of Dolly Parton falling on you.
You're a lot of ways to be a part of what's going on in and around Boston. You can...
Every Thursday, Metro Guy's part of the Patriot Ledger, the Little Sun, the Belmont Citizen, and many other high-quality suburban newspapers. If you don't already read your local paper, try it. Then on Thursday, read Metro Guy.
13 minutes now before 8 o'clock, and our chief engineer's favorite artist, Claude, here he comes, man.
Oh, you must just know, Mr. Robin.
This is Toby Bo.
Toby Bo.
I love this
song.
Yeah, Toby Bo on
RKO.
Yeah,
we've got trouble.
Okay.
Something is not right.
WRKO with Charlie&Harrigan. Good morning. It's almost 10 minutes now before 8 o'clock in the morning, and Charlie&Harrigan has some Patriot Monday Night Football tickets to give away in just a little bit. Oh, wait, let us check in with Ed Walsh.
Yeah, I'm here.
Oh, there you are.
Okay.
I never know anymore. You know, you duck down behind the microphone there, and I don't know whether you're there or not. But good morning at any rate. What's going on?
Well, thanks, Charlie, and good morning, everyone.
Right now, 51 degrees at Logan International Airport. It's 51 downtown at the Government Center. This is Ed Walsh, 68 News and Information. Now, from WRKO, Charlie&Harrigan.
Oh, Ed Walsh is so talented. Such a talented guy.
Isn't he really? What his secret is?
What's this?
Every morning he puts on his suede shorts and takes a jello bath.
Well, boy, it sure smoothed him out. Something did happen. WRKO Boston, the album station. It's 8:02 with Charlie&Harrigan.
Well, it's true. Irv has a little trouble here. He tried to give his mother-in-law a light and accidentally set fire to her mustache. Is she gonna beat the tar out of him?
WRKO. Good morning, everybody. It's Charlie&Harrigan. It's 7 minutes after 8 o'clock, and that's Jackson Brown running on empty. And we are probably doing the same thing this morning. Got some Patriot tickets to give away. Just those. First, here's Herman Willis in the newsroom with all the news we need to know. Herman Willis, come in, please.
Good morning. This is Herman Willis, our award-winning mobile news chief. Minutes ahead, 1 second. Now, scientists at MIT are trying to cure impotence with injections of starch. We'll have Phil at 11.
Linda, you complain every month. I told you, try Mopgun's pain relievers don't have. Before, during, and after. My doll. Use only as directed.
WRKO Commuter Control now with Carolyn Murdoch. Carolyn? Hold it, Carolyn. Start it again.
I'm here. Am I here now?
There you are.
I'm there. Okay. From WRKO Commuter Control, this is Carolyn Murdoch.
I'm absolutely in love with this bird now. I just want you to know that. I have her favorite song here. Here it is.
I've got you under my car.
Thank you, Miss Murdoch.
KO Charlie&Harrigan doing a little reminiscing with the Little River Band. It's 13 minutes now after 8 o'clock in the morning, and CNH can only tell you that we've got some tickets to give away. We gave away a pair of tickets a little earlier this morning to the Baltimore game, if you want to call it that, which is coming up on Monday. And have you heard anything, by the way, about Burt Jones? He's not ready to come back, is he?
I don't think so. I hope not, anyway.
Yeah, well, they need revenge, and they need it bad, ladies and gentlemen. They've had, 76 points scored on them in the first two games, something like that.
It's been incredible.
Tremendously, and we're going to see if we can't extend that a little bit next Monday night.
Baltimore has had more points scored on them than the Red Sox in the last 5 days.
I won't go along with that.
Oh, yeah, no, it's the truth.
I take good care.
care of what worked hard for me. So for my car, it's a TP.